Aircraft armed.
Aircraft before taking off.
Taking off.
Takeoff time recorded.
The UAS program's been in motion since around 2021 with active pilots in the department, but we've taken a very deliberate approach, and it's a crawl, walk, run. And so we've taken very incremental, calculated steps on how we've grown the program, added mission sets. I mean, obviously, the use case for UAS, some would say, is unlimited. For us, it's been very important to kind of just crawl into the space. We've learned a lot from our federal partners, taken a lot of pages out of their playbook, which has also helped us really accelerate to the level that we're at now, because we didn't have to have all the learning lessons of our partners.
Over the past couple of years, I've seen the growth in the program and the potential that it has for the department on the information technology side, on the immediate intel side for our wildland fires, as well as our search and rescue missions.
All risk fire department, and we have a lot of mission sets that we're already currently conducting, whether that's vehicles over the edges, we're on hazmats, providing some overwatch to the teams that were going downrange. And so, yeah, we are looking at doing small-scale cargo delivery. We have had some success in that lane already from a test and evaluation standpoint. We've delivered flotation devices to folks in the ocean. We've delivered two-way radio communications to lost hikers on search and rescue events. We've even delivered an AED to a cardiac event that happened well up on a hillside on a trail system. So that was obviously a win, you know, getting into that space, but we're really new there, and so we're taking our time on making sure that we have it right before we implement that as a statewide training. So we've already been implementing aerial ignition for about 2 years now within Cal Fire. Now we have the demand. People see that there's a use case for us to come give them a hand, so now we just need to build our bench.
The best part about this program is we don't know all of the places where it's going to go, and that's everything from the cargo delivery side that's just in its early phases of testing, all the way through the more constant intel side where you might see UAS on the fixed wing side to be able to hover over or take an orbit over your small or medium-sized fires so that the IC can have constant intel, where right now we have a much more limited time frame. So you can almost always have the eye in the sky over your fire.